for this, I find it really difficult not to think that Na'Vi will win, James, because they have Simple and Guardian on Cobblestone, and Simple used to be able to basically win Cobblestone by himself. Obviously, this, you know, having so many other amazing players on the team does shift the dynamic, and they have had some issues since they removed Zeus and put Simple into the lineup. So, you know, it's hard to say where they're at right now, but obviously the Mage is the most important thing. This is where the impact has to happen, and this is where the fruits of the labor of much work and practice.
Mouthboards, mouthboards, triple smoke, triple Molotov.
Nice.
What is this sorcery, Dan? What is this sorcery? We've got Na'Vi seized with the defuse kit and the high explosive grenade, but we've got triple smoke, triple Molotov. I have all kinds of question marks.
Well, the good thing is that Na'Vi aren't pushing, so maybe we'll actually get to see what these, what the intended purpose is behind this madness.
This is some Riddler tier nonsense going on right now. Where will these smokes go? See, now it seems Versus Pro looking to maybe smoke off some choke points in the A bomb site with their smokes, and or have some post-plant smokes to delay. But what will we see from mousesports? All going over towards A. You can deploy a bunch of grenades from there. You can smoke off the balcony and the door, if I'm not mistaken, from those positions. Some light dueling here. You see Flamey in position on the crate in case any madness should happen, but the A site is very weakly defended.
This is good, James. This is good for us. This is, the dream might be real. We might actually see all the grenades and exactly what, you know, they're supposed to do. Uninterrupted strategy from mousesports with the smokes and the Molotovs. Oh, the wall of smokes! Alright, that's awesome. Okay, now we've got the mollies. Where are they gonna go? Simple's gonna try to wrap around here. There's one opening. They know that, because they've designed this strategy.
The Molotovs, know.
And that's it! Just carpet bombing the prop site!
The site on fire!
And Simple had to leave.
Yeah, he got that GTFO, and now he's trying to get himself back in. Double P coming in for a T-side, but no frags just yet. Somebody kill someone! He's got no bullets left! Teammates being tagged as well. Flamey heavily tagged. Somebody die, please, in a situation! There's still 10 players on the server, Dan! What is going on? Finally, Spitty gets taken down. See what else the CTs can do. Simple doesn't know where to go now. This is crazy. They were not prepared for this. Next level strats from mousesports, but the bomb's being defused. End of flame. Just Prime Seas has made it. That is...
what is this?
Disgusting! What a retake! That was mental. They got so far before throwing the grenades.
Is this Counter-Strike on the circus?
Mousesports have got, like, they've got Sleeve of Wizard, Dan. They've got tricks up their sleeves. But still, Na'Vi with that hero defuse. The hero defuse.
This round was just so weird. Oh my god. All right, let's just move on. Let's move on. Triple UMP. And for Mousesports, we've got a couple flashbangs, mostly, well, mostly stock pistols, to be honest. A couple PT-50s and a Deagle, that's it. Deagle's on Nico. Oh, and already sees he's going to take a meat shot from Nico, so a bit of damage being done. But it's hard to expect too much from mousesports in a round like this. It's really all about Na'Vi not losing more than one player. That's the winning, that would be a massive win for them. And mousesports, they would be really happy with getting more than one frag out of such a low investment. And with a couple flashbangs, they should be able to win some positions at least. They're already pretty deep on the A-long area.
Flashbang. Two flashes for Speedy. Seems there's going to be a play to plant the bomb, if you ask me, in this round. And I know, well, we'll come to it in a bit. We've got a flash on the Na'Vi side. Simple having a look with the UMP. Not much to lose, and he will lose his weaponry. Something collected from mousesports, but the longer they take, the more CTs are streaming into the A site. Now the bomb plot looks very unlikely. High explosive flying in as well. The margins are getting ever so slight for mousesports in this round, but the rotation's coming in. They are rotating down like the dial of a watch. Guardian's alone on the site. He's got the range though, and in the meantime, Chris J doing more damage towards the A site. He's keeping people entertained. So, Guardian may be exploited. There's a potential round win now for mousesports, but again, they have no armor.
Yeah, this is really weird. Guardian has to defend here against three players. And if they get the timing right, I don't think they necessarily have the timing to do it. They are moving in here. Guardian's gonna be careful of that drop position. He is exposed, but Nico doesn't hit the instant kill that he needed onto Guardian. Looks like Guardian will hold this against three players, and the last player, Chris J, is way too far away. And he's actually, this actually kind of sucks for Chris J, because he's gonna basically save just a UMP, which is I mean, it's just not worth it. Even if you were just to like lose one round, the 1400 loss bonus, you're still not making money there.
You can see Guardian, money, sorry. Guardian was also playing the clock just in case he went down. He was trying to make sure there was not enough time to plant the bomb, so smart stuff by him. But, I mean, mousesports, like... mousesports, you know, like some people, you know, when they're feeling depressed or something, they hit the bottle. Like Janko will watch mousesports games, and it seems like they are more prepared. I mean, yes, we are two rounds into the major as far as mousesports are concerned, but that pistol run was next level from them. So I do wonder what else they have to show us as this major continues. They're on the buy now with the AKs coming out. Chris J, of course, continuing with that UMP. And he will be, it's funny, Chris J with the worst range gun is holding the A site. Meanwhile, Seeds with a cheeky boost, gonna survive, but that will slow down the mousesports advance.
Yeah, it has been pretty much halted, but their presence is still going, still making some noise there towards drop. Na'Vi just biding their time at the moment, waiting for mousesports to make the play. They do have a few grenades left, a couple of smokes, a couple of flashbangs. Still more noise towards A, B rather, and almost no noise ever towards A, so that justifies Na'Vi having basically four players towards B at the moment. And now mousesports actually doubling back. And they haven't cleared out any forward presence towards the A side of the map, but it's unlikely that there would still be forward presence just because they've been pressuring B so hard that normally forces a reaction to cause one player to play passively on A.
See how Nico's just taken the jump to suggest that he's dropped into, fallen into the drop. And he saw a two-man peek coming from Na'Vi, and they see nobody's there. They realize they are being baited. See Flamey now rotating towards the A site. Edwards in position to quickly make it through connector as well. And we see the charge from mousesports now. Four players coming in. Nico looking to get some flank action done as well. No bomb spotted for Na'Vi just yet, so they're not exactly sure, but the rotation's coming in towards A. Here comes Seize. Will they be in position though?
And then it's wrapping around the APC. Flamey posting quite the defense there, opening things up. No frag for Seize there. He's very close to the UMP, but not quite. One versus two here. Edward comes in. Already two kills for him at the moment, but he's up against Dennis now in this one versus one. He's got a play against the bombers. Very close there. Almost not enough time to plant. 1 second was left, but Dennis managed to do it in the nick of time. And where is Edward? That is now the question that currently haunts Dennis. Spots him though, but no connection. Edward looking for it by the tree, finds the headshot, claims himself his third kill in the round. Nice clutch. Edward, really a very nice round from him, saving Na'Vi, but mousesports, they did a lot of work there.
Yeah, and I think Dennis was unlucky not to get the headshots in that first angle he took up, but nice angles taken by him in general. But Edward, the sexy man talisman of the Na'Vi side, and take the round for his team and keep the clean sheet. Perhaps a touch of frustration there. Not surprising considering the effort put into that pistol round as well. So, you know, psychologically not a best start for mousesports, never mind the score. They've chosen to force it up. We have the UMP onto Lowell, the rest of them with Tech-9s, P250 and a Deagle onto Nico, of course. So they've got a moving accuracy and the Nico accuracy in play. We'll see if Na'Vi can survive. Ooh. Very early peak, perhaps not. Nico off to an early start and he wants that AWP immediately.
Oh no, that is... Oh, the grenades are coming in. He's taking some hits here, down to 41. But that is quite the steal. Man, walking in there. Seeds got a grenade in his hand. Oh, so is Nico! So awkward. The flick comes in. It's not good. Seeds from above the crate, able to take down Nico and somehow escape with his life.
That is divine intervention. 4-on-4, and again, moving accuracy. The Tech Knight coming into play. Down goes Blamey, but the trades are coming in. Edward on the tree, getting two for his team. And one goes down there, mid on the clock, and it's only Lowell. Insta-trade, two players surviving for Na'Vi, but it's 4-0. That's all they care about at this point. Looking for AWP, AWP found. But again, Nico, that Deagle, ever dangerous. He does horrible things with that.
He really, really does. Oh man, surgical precision. And I actually agree with you. You said it, you know, yourself, it's very early to kind of make the judgment, but it does seem like mousesports have way better rounds. Like the way that they're executing the rounds, you can see the plan, the tactics are pretty tight, the movement is tight. It looks like they actually know what they're doing throughout the entire round, which may sound a bit weird, but on Cobblestone, historically, it's not necessarily been a map where on the T side, they always look very, like they absolutely know what the plan is at all times. But so far, they look very driven. Maybe that's why we saw a bit of frustration from Nico, because they have worked so incredibly hard to turn things around for mousesports.
Worth noting as well, that peak from Guardian was insane. To peak like that's very dangerous peak. and he was punished accordingly. Although, again, it's Na'Vi with the clean sheet. The whitest whites. mousesports making some steps. Simple will hear the rifle being reloaded. He can let his team know there is some presence towards A. In the lower area, no less, and his team will pop flash him in, so he knows they've probably gone to the high ground. But how many are there? At least one. Maybe it's likely that it's more than one. Na'Vi holding formation for the time being. Super deep smoke grenades. We saw Virtus Pro trying to push behind these smoke grenades, but Na'Vi will just leave them be and keep passive positioned towards the end of the plateau. 40 seconds left. We've got presence and drop from mousesports. They're running the clock down as they like to, but they have no frags just yet, and I'm starting to worry.
Yeah, I like how they're mixing up the pace. Let's see if it works out. Nico can't get himself the entry towards connector. That would have helped, but there is still a lot of success that he potentially had in this push. Look at the chaos the smokes are causing. It's going the way of Na'Vi currently, still holding strong onto their original defensive setup. And mousesports with 10 seconds left. This is all but over, I think. What on earth can the remaining players possibly do here except just survive with what they have intact? Spitty will not be able to do that. Low will, but again, another round from mousesports shut down by Na'Vi, and it is almost a little bit sad to see for them, because we can
don't leave me hanging, bro.
Because they've had a lot of great rounds. Like, you can see the way that they're building the rounds together. They've got good coordination and so on, and some of them have been very close and down to the clutches. So mousesports, I feel unlucky so far to have only zero rounds on the board.
So I think we have a technical timeout. I heard someone had disconnected. We'll get clarification if it's a technical or technical.
A technical.
It is indeed a technical, right? I think production just said it was technical. So hopefully that will be resolved shortly. 5-0 for Na'Vi though, and you have to wonder, as Na'Vi, if they continue to rack up rounds here and mousesports stay on a zero, again, if you put in all this work and then you have literally no success, what does that do to you psychologically?
And also, if you consider just that Na'Vi are always such a dangerous team, to be able to let's say you know, mousesports, after all the work they've put in, of course, you know, we had almost a 6 month gap between this major and the last one, so that's a lot of time for a tournament. And the major is a tournament. If your team hasn't been doing very well recently, you make it deep in that one tournament, the major, that just makes all the difference to your team. And if they were to just out of the gates get a victory against Na'Vi in this early stages of the Swiss system, then that would be, I think, very encouraging, obviously, and would put them in a very good mental space to not have to fight from a loss straight away. And I would love to see mousesports in that position. I think they're in a spot right now where they could actually surprise a lot of people. And that said, the same thing goes for Na'Vi. We know how much skill they have on the team with the likes of Simple, and it seems like they initially shoehorned him into the team, and they've had time to work on how it really can, you know, work as a unit now to really become, you know, a team that can win a major. So much going on for both these teams.
On the subject of Swiss systems and Swiss things, I highly recommend Gruyere cheese. Send me your thoughts on Gruyere cheese on the tweeters. Maybe we'll extend the discussion. So there was just some money restoration following the reconnect, and we are live again. So we have Lowell with the AK and four players on a pistol. Of course, mousesports are at maximum loss bonus, $3,400 coming their way should they lose this round. Even more if they plant the bomb. So we'll see what they can offer Na'Vi in this round. Wouldn't say it's much. They've got three Molotovs, two flashbangs, and a smoke grenade. Initial molly from Spitty, and Na'Vi will send some of their own. So fast play coming in. Tech 9's going through, and TT's off to a good start. Guardian taking a player down. He's been tagged though, down 16 HP. C's unable to get any spray in, so the bombs should get planted. No, it's been dropped.
This is really weird, actually. Na'Vi having to retake in this fashion. They actually had an unconventional start to the round. mousesports taking the right way to attack this one, but still unable to plant the bomb. That is so, so unfortunate. Na'Vi basically gave them the bomb plant. You can see the only people they had on the bomb site were both on drop. There was no one on the actual site. They got the bomb site immediately. That is very unlucky that Mousesports did not get a plant right there.
Yeah, I mean, they can more or less fall by in this round anyway. Christian had 6250, but he's opted for an AK. But more money is always good. You can use it in further rounds. So, such is life. 6-0 for Na'Vi. Will Mousesports win a round anytime soon? That's a question. Spitty on the Galil, so indeed they needed that bomb plant.
So what do they have in store here? I mean, you can see the difference. We just saw Virtus Pro on this map and how they ran the CT setups. We saw Snacks Alone a lot on the A side of the map. Look how different it is from Na'Vi. They've got three players towards the A side of the map. And, oh, this is NIP-esque smokes going over towards B here. And it's an awesome smoke setup because it can really suggest a B rush. But the positions, you either come in late with the B rush or you go to A with the split. There's lots of options to play off those nades. But Na'Vi, you've got such a good setup. They're all over this.
Yeah, I mean, they started to rotate from their deep position towards long, but they just got passive areas. So they haven't cleared the site by any means, but maybe Chris J will do it by force. Edward playing around the smoke. This could be huge. Will Mousesports bide their time though? This grenade, oh, never mind. He might go back to it. All the players getting dropped. Guardian is going nuclear at the moment. Three kills here. Then it's the last man standing, and Edward's there up close to take him down as well. So yes, Mousesports, they sold the fake towards the B bomb site, but all it did, as far as A is concerned, is rotate Na'Vi away from danger. But there were still three men on the site, so they were in very good positions, and Guardian is Guardian, and that's always a problem unless he's dead.
It's so interesting, the CT setups we're seeing out of Na'Vi. The fact that they have seven rounds on the CT side of Cobblestone, that's already so many rounds on the CT side. It used to be with Na'Vi before that you were scared of their T side. If they got three or four rounds on the CT side, they can still just crush you with a very solid T side. That would often happen. And so to see the kind of setups from Na'Vi, like Guardian was on the AWP in B on drop zone. And the only other guy on B was playing by the statue. It's just such a strange setup with aggressive three people towards long, and that's something they've run in more than one round. So we're seeing unconventional stuff from Na'Vi, and that might be throwing Mousesports off a little bit.
Another technical timeout seized, just resolving some connection issue to reconnect to the server. On the plus side, there was a recent update from, I don't know if it's a back authentication error, for example, but with those disconnects now, there was a recent update, so they happen at the end of a round as opposed to the middle of the round. So that's a plus, you know, for when it does happen. That is much better for the integrity of the game. The integrity of Mousesports on Cobblestone may be called into question with the current 7-0, but again, they have shown an improvement despite the complete lack of rounds at the moment. And it seems they're going to go for another half buy. Again, they are at maximum loss bonus all day, so they can go for these buys. They might as well at this point. But not seeing much of a note. I think their best opportunity was the pistol run, really. And beyond that, Na'Vi looked pretty comfortable.
Yeah, Mousesports have had some good opportunities here or there, but it's interesting as well because a team that has more structure generally has a way that they're looking at the game, which means that even if they go 7-0 down, they're not going to lose as much confidence as long as they feel like they're making good plays and they're just being, those players are being beaten for whatever reason. You know, it's always very possible when you're up against a very great opponent that they can just do that. So I don't think their confidence will yet be knocked too much. So can they do something with these Tech Nines? We'll have to see.
Do you wonder about the choices of Na'Vi? Will they go aggressive, knowing the situation? Simple's in a nice position, especially as Flamey is spotting three players early, and in comes Simple to clean up. Spitty looking for the close quarters. He's going to get wrecked immediately. Simple seeing the bomb now, and he's going to head forward. So, again, he is in pug mode. Chris J's gone beyond, but again, we're not really expecting one. Even if there's one kill, that is a lovely swipe from Flamey. Nothing given to Mousesports. No margins, nothing at all. They are being choked. Nico alone of the Deagle. So, just looking for some highlight reel frags at this point because there's minimal impact that he can have. Zeus has got 2700 in the bank, so there's some damage to be done. Again, there are still seven rounds to play for following the conclusion of this one.
Yeah, everything still counts. If he can maybe get out a couple frags, that would be super sick. And, ooh, misses that opportunity. That was the one. That was the opportunity, that first shot there. Unfortunate for Nico. And indeed, as you highlighted, great position for Simple to respond to the info that Flamey had. Lots of red dots on the radar suddenly there for Simple to to work off of, and that 8-0 scoreline is just so insane. And look at this, that really tells you the whole story. And one thing as well is that Guardian for a long time was considered the best AWPer in the world, and he definitely dropped off after his injury, and he had time off because of the injury, came back, never was quite the same, much like a lot of players we've seen in the past who rise to heights, and the injuries, man, they can really be problematic.
Edward looks like Edward's younger brother. Without all his locks, all his hair, he looks like his own younger brother. It's really crazy. The unpause has come in. We're going to be back into the game soon. Again, we've got the full by. Look at him. He looks like he's 10 years younger. That's insane.
It's so weird. And his Edward had like one of the most respectable beards.
He looks like he's 12. Then 8-0 for Na'Vi. We've got the AWP onto Chris J. Can mousesports find their first round? There's still opportunity for mousesports to get all the way back into this half. Nico leading the charge. I think it's one of those rounds where Nico says, all right, let me go and kill everyone. Although the nades are being deployed, so perhaps the wall of smoke will come in and the team will deliver as well. So far, so good for Nico. Speedy going down. The bomb's on the floor for a second. Guardian up close, waiting for someone to push past the smoke. I think it might be linked by a teammate there, but down goes Dennis. Still good for Na'Vi. They can flash behind Guardian's position as well and give him more advantages. He's coming forward. Oh, Chris J gets a grenade out. There he goes. More flashbangs, and there's almost nothing here for mousesports. Edward, the only man to go down. Lower gets his bell rung. Flamey finishes him off. 9-0. Na'Vi starting to stack the cash.
I think it can't be understated how well Guardian played his position around the smoke. It was very awkward, and he had to hold that spot, and he had to be convinced that his teammates would cover the spot that he wasn't looking in, and he's playing close range, scoped up with an AWP among smoke. That is just very difficult, but he held it like a pro, because that's what he is. And that's one of the reasons actually why he used to be known as the best AWPer in the world, is it wasn't just because of the crazy flick shots he could hit, but it was actually his decision making was so good. It wasn't all just crazy raw talent. His decision making was always something to study, I think, as any avid Counter-Strike player. And mousesports, now they've resorted to UMPs, James. That's what this is about now, UMPs.
Yeah, again, max loss bonus. They could still have the AKs in the following round, so they're just trying to buy as best they can, but life is tough against Na'Vi on Cobblestone, it seems, here on the first day of the E-League Major in Atlanta, in Hip-Hop Central. 9 out of 10 players towards the B bomb site. Chris J gets the opening frag, but can they get more than that? They need all the frags.
All the frags. Edward, let's see if he is... Let's see if the power's in the beard. He's got a good position there, finds himself one. A trade comes in, Nico from the tree position, able to do some damage there, as Flamey is going to be taken down as well. This is really interesting right now. It's Simple against two players, trying to get that initial kill, but low with the UMP. They have three UMPs and two Tech Nines, and they have won their first round, James. That's one on the board, but it is one against the towering score. That is the 9 that Na'Vi have on the CT side of Cobble, no less. So it is quite the climb, quite the journey. They will have to assemble a fellowship to make this kind of a journey, James.
Welcome to the scoreboard, mousesports. Instant timeout from Na'Vi. Soon as that round was concluded, let's do a timeout. It looks like they might have momentum. Timeout.
Yeah, it's actually interesting. We might see a lot of that. I mean, more tactical usages in a meta sense for the timeouts, because you can time out quite a lot in the new rules.
Lots of discussion as well. Seized such an important person in the jigsaw puzzle that is Na'Vi. 9-1, Simple and Guardian pulling out the big guns now. They've got the cash to splash, and they're going to do that. This is an important round for mousesports. I mean, at this point, every round is important for them. So, not even worth digging into the factors for this particular one. They must win every round at this point. The unpause has come in. It's time to get back into it. So let's see what kind of... I mean, Simple's been playing towards A, and remember back when he was on the flip side and they were playing double ops on Cobblestone, that was a very dangerous, very brittle setup. So I do wonder if we're going to see such aggression from Simple on this occasion, or if he will be taking a different approach. Smoking towards the underpass, but not going to look over the smoke. He'll be holding a passive position, so hashtag new Simple after all.
So mousesports, they creep along that plateau. And there's a lot of presence here from Na'Vi. They are not messing around. Look at Guardian's position. Just chilling there by the top of drop. He's going to spot one. Hits the shot. That's level down. Nade sailing there. He's got some good support in Seize. The Seize is going to win his battle as well. Already two players down. It's no longer a split because drop zone is actually Na'Vi's. But Nico trying to squeeze his way in there. Immediately traded. And somehow, Chris Jane Spitty able to even up the numbers here. But Guardian is still causing problems. That's three for him now.
Simple's like, can I get the last one, please? Simple and Guardian, double ops, look at that, that's glorious. That is a glorious moment right there. Simple and Guardian, crossfire, double AWPs. And who knows how much more of that is to come in this Na'Vi lineup. Those two may write some history together, starting with the boost as well. Lovely stuff from Guardian. 10-1, the worst has happened for mousesports. They've been reset, but they've still got the cash to pull out four AKs. That is a face of frustration.
It's so cool as well, the way they played it, because it's such a bait when you have an AWP in that position, because you know you have to rush that spot to trade frag him, and just the setup with the rifle waiting and seized. That is just such beautiful, efficient counter-strike there. And now mousesports again in the position where they don't have much in the way utility. They're just going to try to get it happening here for themselves with a bum rush onto the B bomb site. And there's the first shot missed, but Edward to pick up the pieces here. Guardian might get a few more shots at this one. Still able to keep himself in position here, but the bomb site's been given to mousesports and they will get the bomb down.
I like that. They don't care about the bomb plant, they care about the retake situation with as many players as possible. So they will keep half the bomb site for their team, but Chris Jade coming in for the flank looking for more players, but they're all on the sites at this point. But now he will be an element of fear. Nico going down on the site, and Spinny's got to put in work. There are still smokes all over the face. Chris Jade putting in more work from the back. That's going to run a distraction to our Spinny to get the second last frag, and Lel comes in as well. Chris Jade's his presence in the back, such a problem for Na'Vi on that retake, and mousesports get their second round.
Yeah, you're right. Exactly. It was the presence was scarier than the actual frags that he made. Completely dominated the thoughts of the Na'Vi players retaking. It's so scary in the back of your mind. There could be a guy to just shut down the round at any time. That is so hard to deal with. And I agree with you. Like, giving up the bomb site there was, I think, it was a really smart choice by Na'Vi. But looks like that drop control from Chris Jade is just too much to deal with. And timeout here from mousesports. Only two rounds on the board. And Na'Vi, they have been really taking a lot of heavy hits to their economy, despite having a 10-2 scoreline. They're actually out of money almost after this buy.
Yeah, I mean, Guardian's buy in this round is $9,850. I think he may have dropped a rifle for Edwards because he was a bit short. So that's a lot of cash being spent.
So there is a chance of five rounds, but five rounds on the T side. Like, having to win 10 rounds on CT side, I think mousesports is a team that can definitely do that on the CT side. They're a great CT side team. It was usually on cobblestone. More often, I would see them having a lot of issues on the T side. So don't want to count them out of this too quickly, but this is a good look here for Na'Vi. They're looking pretty solid.
See how Chris J jumps on the boulder. I think he was anticipating the smoke and trying to see over it. So a little detail if you want to duel AWPers who smoked that position. Chris J, good man to follow. Oh, he didn't say he's watching GoTV for this one. Well, I think it has to be Guardian at this point, the way he's been going off. Get your GoTVs on Guardian. Three rounds main. That allows Guardian to get into an aggressive position. The flashbang that was missing in that previous round where he went for an aggressive peek. Goes for the timing pick in case Nico moved. Ooh, brushing the shoulder there. If he had shoulder pads down, he was dead.
Yeah, how did that not actually hit? That was so close. And in the meantime, mousesports, they've claimed a lot of space towards the A side of the map. So, you know, running that default, trying to get a lot of presence everywhere, keep those question marks over what exactly they are doing for the Na'Vi's defense. And at the moment, the time is already starting to tick away. There's only 40 seconds to go for the play, and mousesports, they're ready now. In a timely manner, I would say, to hit the B-bomb site. But the problem is, Na'Vi are all over the B-bomb site. They've got four players there, simple with a fast rotation from A there too.
There's no room for failure here for mousesports. Two players behind the smoke as well. That smoke may delay things. Guardian, of course, getting the first frag here. And this is falling apart. The bomb's on the floor as well. Mousesports, do they have time to breach? The frag starting to come in for them, but they're at man disadvantage. Edward in a great position just to stop the bomb from going down. Chris J, last man to fall. And again, there wasn't room for error for mousesports when they played a clock that late. Is that actually Edwards? I'm not convinced, right?
It's so weird. I feel like the beard just gave him this. The beard was just so.
How did he get through possible control? I don't understand. But it seems, I don't know, it seems to be doing the trick because it's 11 to 2.
Yeah, honestly, it does seem like the power was not in the beard after all. They, Navi are really. It's not just that they're defending well, it's also that they're reading mousesports very well. Like, mousesports tried to make it look very unclear as to where they were going to go. But in the end, Navi basically had five players pretty much ready to defend straight away onto that swamp site. So, oh, that was. Bye, Chris J. That was a very fast one from Simple, as you would expect.
In the face.
And they've only got Glocks. It's not even fair, James. It's not fair.
The Simple welcoming party is here, and he likes to welcome you by shooting you in the jaw with an AWP for approximately 448 damage. Mere pistols remaining at this point for mousesports. No more UMP buys because that loss bonus isn't there. Things going from bad to worse. There's Nico eliminated. Death by paper cuts in this round for the T side.
And one thing as well is that for mousesports, no matter the end result of this match against Na'Vi, they've got to make. I really hope that they don't get too down on themselves because Na'Vi got off to a really good start on the CT side by playing some unconventional setups, and they put mousesports in kind of a weird place when it came to how their money was and generally. Where Na'Vi was economically, they got so like pretty far ahead, and that enabled them to play from full comfort. So and they also played so very well. So I feel like mousesports, a lot of this is just Na'Vi playing super well on Cobblestone here, which is great to see for any Na'Vi fans out there. Let's see though if mousesports can at least get the last round in the first half. Not the best start though. Blamey in danger is traded eventually, but Simple still a problem.
Oh, the bait is there. Edward boosted once again. Two kills for him. The damage is done. And we are looking at a 13-2 half unless Chris J turns on. They know where the bomb is as well. So life is difficult. And it's going to be hard for Chris J to approach without making scope sounds with his AWP. So he has so much against him at the moment. Minute 10 on the clock. Not sure if he has time to rotate towards B. And Na'Vi may have a read of that, leaving three players in the A site. Oh, Guardian looks away at the wrong time. But still, Chris J has a lot to do.
Yeah, that was quite nice. The problem is that there's a lot of choke points he still has to move through. And there is one smoke grenade still on Navi. I think it was, still on Steast. And interesting that Edward has gone actually into a position which now puts him behind Chris J. And I don't know that he knew. Always coming back in, I think, to position. He's going to shoot him in the back.
And in the back.
There you go. 13-2. Really solid, really solid CT side from the likes of Na'Vi. Cannot be understated. Everything went their way. And I love that we saw some unconventional stuff and some stuff that really takes a lot of confidence. And most importantly for me, James, we saw a great match from Guardian.
Yeah, well, a great half. But, who knows what happens from here, but Na'Vi at the moment are looking scary on Cobblestone. As good as mousesports attempts were on the pistol round, there was not much more after that in that half because Na'Vi were just a beasting. You see how Guardian's matching up to Nico at the moment, but maybe mousesports will have a better time of things on their CT side. But first, they need a successful pistol round.
Yeah, mousesports are a team that I've seen them do a lot of damage to very, very solid teams on their CT side. And as we talk about this, we've got some Guardian highlights here. Maybe he's going to get some more highlights, or maybe it will be Nico's time as we move in onto that CT side.
Yeah, Guardian did a lot of work here, and he's, you know, warming up tournament-wise in the first game. Always good to see him delivering. Again, there's been questions, I think, post-operation to fix his arm from what I think was a footballing injury or something. So, yeah, nice to see Guardian delivering. Game should be underway soon. So again, we've seen some teams, we've seen mousesports now and Virtus Pro with a three-man utility setup on the T pistol. Na'Vi have seized on the grenades. Simple hasn't bought just yet. Everybody else has Kevlar, so we may not see any more shenanigans in that respect. The unpause has come in and it's time for mousesports to deliver. Seem to be in good spirits. Again, it is a Swiss system, so not as harsh as a bracket format.
Yeah, it's actually always fun as well, seeing Nico's face just generally across the course of a match, because he's quite, you can see a lot of the emotions that he runs through, because he holds himself to such an impossibly high standard, as all players do. You want to pick up that trophy at the end of a tournament. Oh, Dennis starts it off. And that is a solid start for mousesports. Now, what do Na'Vi do? They've got at least some grenades on Seeds. There are options here for them to play together as three.
It's not how you start, Dan. It is how you finish, said someone somewhere. And indeed, mousesports, they must complete these rounds. Only two on the board. They need all the rounds in this early start to the second half. Everybody live at the moment. They've got a range advantage with the USPs as well. No P250s here for Na'Vi. Just two honest Glocks. Gone are the days of the burst fire power. Peppering, but no stake.
It's very scary, isn't it? Because rounds like this is where Simple can just turn on God mode, because the odds for him to win it are so low, but that somehow spurs him on to the next level. One versus four now, and it looks a little bit too difficult. Just can't quite get the instant frag that he needs with the Glock. Just as you said, the ranges, they were played out perfectly. Mousesports, they limited the potential for disaster as much as they possibly could, really made it difficult for Na'Vi to try to come back there, and there are the two frags from Dennis that put mousesports just way too far ahead there in that round. And there's a chance now, James. There is a chance for mousesports to get something done here.
The composure of Simple at the end there was quite telling. You know, the player of his caliber in a horrible situation, but still being very patient with the Glock. He understands he needs to slow down to get that accuracy back in the Glock in order to get that kill, whereas some people might just go spam, 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 and then you've lost it all. 10 rounds behind are the mousesports side. A successful pistol. They've gone for a lot of utility, but Chris J gets the M4 as well. And it's UMPs on most of the other players. UMPs will be good against the armor of these force-buying Na'Vi players. Dennis with the MP9. The MP9, actually, one of the unique characteristics it has is that it's reasonably accurate when you're jumping compared to other weapons, although when you're jumping with an MP9, who knows? But always worth knowing. Na'Vi with two smokes, two flashes! Looking to head towards B. Guardian just keeping an eye with the Deagle towards the A site, making sure there's no early flanks on the CT side. Mousesports, can they afford the risk? I don't know. Spitty with an off angle with the UMP, but a numbers game is relevant. The Tech 9 takes him out immediately. Bad start.
Yeah, very bad, but they are controlling things pretty well. Look at the way Chris is backing away, holding down these angles. Does get tagged there pretty severely straight to the helmet, but it's the 3 versus 2. The bomb is actually in the hands of Simple here. He's got a PT-50. He's actually got all the health. And he's got the drop onto Dennis. And now there's an opportunity here for Simple to plant the bomb. This just went from bad to worse for mousesports. Simple's in a great position here to help his team win the round. Seized. I don't know if they know that he's even there. Coming through, taking down Chris J for three. And now it's going to be just Lowell. He's got the UMP. He's been spotted. Simple just toying with him, trying to bait him into chasing him here, and then give an opportunity for his teammate, or maybe not. Simple, he's going to do the damage and secure the round. An unlikely victory for Na'Vi, and you can never count out the Tech 9s, I guess.
That is quite the disaster. Mousesports broke like MC Hammer, Dan. That is not the second round they needed in this half. And that may be the death knell for mousesports in the first match of their 2017 Major here at ELEAGUE in Atlanta. P250s for days. The honest pistol, Dan. The honest pistol. And you can see he knows what chances they've had, what chances have probably been lost. The fourth buy from mousesports. Pistols galore. CZ in tow as well. Always nice to see a CZ. Some flashes, some smoke grenades. But they are at the mercy of their captors.
Well, when there is a Deagle on to Nico, there is always a chance. We've seen it so many times. Will the Na'Vi side run into him, though? It looks like they won't, not to begin with, at least. They are going to be taking their efforts towards the A side of the map. They've already spotted some players towards these positions. and they should have more than enough to deal with it, but they don't have too many grenades, so that could actually help mousesports out quite a lot in doing some damage here. Oh no! Guardian taking a grenade there from a teammate.
That's a bad miss.
That is a bad miss. Poor Guardian.
Dennis and Chris J have the opportunity to pincer these places, squeeze and sandwich them with the rotation coming in, so Na'Vi needs to be very careful. There's slight opportunity, but opportunity nonetheless here for the mousesports side, and it gets a bit better. Lowell getting a bit greedy there, and that's what it cost him. Spitty with a nice angle, but he can't help his teammates. Opportunities are being lost. They had the bomb, they've lost the bomb, and now Spitty is alone with the P250. He won't last long. Match point, Na'Vi.
Yeah, looks like they are about to close it down. They have so many opportunities to do it in. I mean, mousesports are going to be up against 12 match points here, so that is...
That's a bad
Oh my god. Oh dear. Oh dear. It's all okay though. Everything's fine. It's all good. So, what do we have here for mousesports? We've got a UMP, bunch of deagles. And at this point, it's going to be very hard for them to believe in the comeback with such limited resources to work with. But if Dennis can start them off again, that would be great. Of course, he will get flashed off immediately, so nothing going just yet. But Na'Vi will force the issue into the middle position, into the underpass, looking to get themselves fairly quickly onto that A bomb site. And I like the pace of this from Na'Vi. Oh, see you later, Chris.
That's not nice. Maybe the comeback is Rael, Dan, because Israel's nowhere near Atlanta and mousesports are nowhere near the comeback. Flashbangs galore, Edward fighting Spitty right in front of him. And the numbers should surely go down yet more. Nico, though, he's got an angle on the bomb after taking Guardian down. Edward looking for more. He sees Loic and raises it off for his teammate, but Spitty doesn't seem to know there's a two-man! How did that happen? He saw him! Where's the communication? Edward trying to fix mistakes. Nico's been taken down. That leaves Dennis with 20 HP. And that's going to be that. 16-3. Na'Vi take a solid first map in their major. Mousesports crushed like an aluminium can. I don't know what else to say. I mean, we saw...